the financial capital of India, that is Mumbai, and that has witnessed a massive vaccine fraud. Now, let's tell you what's happened in the case as far as latest developments are concerned. Now, the residential society in Mumbai, which reported the first case of a fraud vaccination drive, was duped of 4 lakh rupees by the gang. Fraudsters promised to give vaccination certificates 15 days after the drive. Mumbai police has confirmed that it's the same gang that was that has held 9 such fraud vaccination drives across Mumbai. 4 of the gang members have been arrested. Few others are absconding. Other places where these fraud drives were held include a college, offices and a production house. For more on this, I'm joined by my colleague Mayuresh on the broadcast. Good morning, Mayuresh. I think this is the first time we have come to know the financial aspect of this drive, and 4 lakh rupees have been duped off these beneficiaries in this upscale society in Mumbai. What more can you tell us about the modus operandi of this vaccination fraud gang?
See, this particular society was not only the society where these fraudsters have arranged the camp. There were certain 9 such locations or 9 such camps these people organized throughout Mumbai and in Thane. So if we talk about the modus operandi, one of the person who used to pose as a marketing or the sales head, he used to approach these societies with the offer of a vaccination camp. He used to negotiate cost of the vaccination somewhere around 1200 rupees. And after that, a camp gets organized. They used to tell that this camp is on behalf of or in association with Kokilaben Hospital, because one of the person used to work there as an employee. And after that, they used to manage the people, and they used to conduct this camp. While conducting the camp, they didn't allow anyone to take selfie. Usually, if you remember, if you see that people do take selfies after getting the jab or while getting the jab, but they didn't allow anyone. Also, while registering, they basically used to just put the data in the Excel sheet. Also, people who received the jab, they never got any kind of OTP immediately, which usually people get after their details get uploaded on Cowin app or Cowin website. It's only based on the Aadhaar card. They used to fill the data. After that, they used to give them a jab. After giving the jab, they used to tell them that you will receive certificates after a few days, because it is not the case. If your details are there uploaded on the Cowin app, and if you get the jab, your certificate will come within 5 to 10 minutes on the Cowin app or the Aarogya Setu app itself. So this was the modus operandi. Also, while charging 1200 rupees, they used to charge GST also, but they didn't give any kind of receipt to anybody. So this was the modus operandi of these people, that they used to approach the societies, corporate house, production houses, also one of the college which has just issued the statement that even they, even the similar kind of people, the similar set of people, same people had organized a camp almost for all the students in the age group between 18 to 44 trustees as well as staff of that particular college. And now they are going to launch a formal complaint with the Mumbai police.
All right, Mayuresh, Mumbai police has given details about the role all these accused played, specifically Mahendra Singh, Sanjay Gupta and Chandan Singh. For the benefit of our viewers, could you explain like what each accused did and how they carried out this entire fraud?
Absolutely, this was not limited to 3 to 4 people. This is a big gang, what Mumbai police have told us. But as of now, they have arrested 4 people and 1 person has been detained, and he will be brought back to Mumbai from Madhya Pradesh. So 1 person, as I said, who used to work in a medical fraternity or in the medical field, he used to basically manage all other people. 1 person used to meet the societies, imposing that he is a person from the Kokilaben Hospital and he's authorized person. He can conduct the camp, and he used to give them offer. And he used to negotiate the price, whereas other accused used to manage the vials. So right now, even Mumbai police is not sure whether these vials which they have got it, whether they are legal vials, or we can say whether they are not the expired ones. So that clarity, even the BMC is yet to get, even the Mumbai police is yet to get. Another person, another accused person, used to manage this camp on the spot. He used to manage everything, including the data entry, and 2 other people. people who were also involved in that, they have basically access to this IT thing, IT system. They have hacked the system. They have stolen the data from the hospital, and they used to feed that data in the system. And that's why all these people have got the certificates from different hospitals.
All right. Thank you, Mayuresh, for getting us those important details and bringing us up to speed with how this entire fraud unfolded in Mumbai. With that, it's a wrap. Stay tuned to Mirror Now for more news and updates. You can visit our website, mirrornownews.com. You can follow us on Twitter, Instagram, and Telegram. Thank you for watching. Stay safe.